Obstacles are those things, those frightful things you see when you take your eyes off your goal. Oh, yeah, you may be seated. I don't want to keep you standing. Okay, Henry Ford said this. But he didn't know what he kind of meant. But he was right. The goal for us is God. Sometimes it's easy to veer off our goal. We see this most of the time, kind of like Peter. Like Jesus was walking on the water. He was walking, had his eyes on the goal. But then he saw his troubles in front of him. He took his eyes off of God. So he started to sink. And so, like God loves us so much, he stuck his hand out so he could pick him up and brush him off. God is always there to lend a hand when you're in a trouble. Faith is what brings us closer to God. It's kind of like a bond. In chemistry, you have ionic bonds and covalent bonds. An ionic bond is a weak bond. You can break it through water. Covalent bonds, they're really strong. That's kind of like us. We need to have faith like a covalent bond. It doesn't break. And faith in God can help through hard times no matter what. And he will take you out of it when you at least expect it. There's always a hand. He's always there reaching you. You may not never see it because your trouble's right in front of you. But when you get past it, you know there's a hand picking you up. A lot of people say, if we're in trouble, why does he not help us right away? That's simple. God has a certain time that he wants to get you out. You never know if you might reach someone that is in that same trouble. If it's what you do that reaches people. In Psalms chapter 18, verse 28, it says, "Thou wilt light my candle. The Lord my God will lighten my darkness." Verse 29, "For by thee I have run through a troop, and my God I've leaped over a wall." Our troop is the storm we're going through. It's not something we can't see, but you just know it's there. We can't get over it. But with God, we can leap over anything. We can leap over mountains. We can leap over a dog. So God can help us do many things, but all we have to do is have faith in him. It brings us closer together. Here's a way to picture faith that can help you get out of trenches. We're a tree, just an ordinary tree. But for a tree to survive, it has to have soil and water. But soil for us is God. Our roots is our faith and love in him. And so when you have that trouble, you believe in him. It just, your roots dig deeper in God. So you cannot fall. So the more deep you get, the more he protects you. The more you're surrounded by his glory. So when a storm blows through, God keeps you upright. No matter how hard the storm blows, the devil can't touch you because your roots are so good and so deep in God that the wind is not even strong enough. Doesn't even faze you. God doesn't like to see us hurt, but he puts trials in front of us so we can get closer to him, so we can dig deeper into the dirt, so we can get more close to him, more be surrounded by who he is. Psalms 27:5, "In the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock." See, God loves us too much to let us hurt. All he asks of us to have is faith, because he will protect you no matter what. He has certain reasons why you go through these trials. because these obstacles, they're just too big. But with Him, you can do anything. You know, trials happen to everyone. God says trials is going to come upon us and all that. But it's how you deal with it, how you get closer to God. And it's just when you deal with it in a certain way, it's like you're getting closer to your ultimate prize, God. God's your ultimate prize. God is something that we all want because He's wonderful, glorious, and joyful. And you know, my grandma, or my mom's mom, was a great example of faith. She, you know, she was handicapped. She had one leg. So, like, mom, she couldn't really get a job because she was handicapped. Nobody wanted to take her. And that would drop my faith in God. She couldn't provide for her family because she didn't have enough money to provide food. And so, and it shows, like, she ran out of gas. And she touched the car and said, "Jesus' name, I don't have the money to fix this car." And the car started. Mom, sometimes we do silly things as kids. She stuck a fork or spoon in a microwave. And that's all they had. And so she turned it on and it blew up. Well, she laid her hand on that. Okay, you know, she's like, "Lord, this is all I have. God, I don't have the money to get another microwave. In Jesus' name, fix this." It works. We still have the microwave today. Even in worse condition, she kept faith in God. I can't imagine how many people she reached. Only if I could have met her to know how much faith it would be like to have in God. Because you think of it, that lady had everything against her, but she kept in faith in God because she wanted to hit the ultimate prize. We need to have that much faith, knowing He will provide for us. Don't let the devil get a hold of you and let him destroy what you have. God is ultimate. He knows you have God. And he doesn't like God, so He doesn't want you to have it. So have faith when you're in trouble. You may feel like you're in the deepest trenches, may never even get out, but there's always a lending hand there. He's always there waiting for you. He's waiting. He wants to pull you up. And just remember, when everything seems to be going against you, remember, airplanes take off against the wind, not with it. Thank you.
I want some chicken nachos cooked in that microwave just as soon as I can get them. And for all of you girls that are around Corey's age, he does have a girlfriend, but that can change. She's about 200 miles away. So I think you did a great job, don't you?